The title in English is The Grass Castle, but I think the French title is much nicer, Le Murmure du Vent. It's much more musical and poetic, isn't it? It's beautiful. I think the French are very poetic. So this is a book set in the high and ancient wild mountains of Australia, beautiful country where very few people live. Perhaps there used to be a few cattlemen that lived up there, and before that, the indigenous Aboriginal people of Australia, but never had many people living there. Very wild, windswept country. And also up there live the extraordinary mobs of kangaroos that are a central part of this story. It's also a story of the people who are connected with and lived in those mountains, several generations of people, and their connection to this country, including the Indigenous people, and what happens when that strong connection with country is broken. So it's a story about friendship, a beautiful friendship between an older woman who's in her 80s and who's not particularly well, but is travelling okay, thinking about her past life in the mountains, which she loved very much. And it's also the story of a young woman who's studying kangaroos. She's an ecologist, and she has difficulties from her own past, from her childhood. And it's about their friendship and the things they do to help each other. But it all centres around a story of kangaroos in the mountains. So I'm a veterinarian. I've been a vet for 30 years now, but I've always loved to write. I'm a very different veterinarian to an ordinary veterinarian. I do work with small animals like dogs and cats, but I also work extensively with Australian native animals. So like Abby in Le Murmure du Vent, I have worked with kangaroos and followed them in the mountains and radio tracked them at night under a spray of beautiful stars. But I've also worked with many other Australian native animals, koalas, many possums and gliders, all little marsupials. I've even worked with pythons, snakes in Australia. And I've worked down in Antarctica with seals, which came into my first book that was published in France, La Mémoire des Embruns. So I have many amazing experiences to draw upon to tell my stories about wild places, wild landscapes, people, the extraordinary lives of ordinary people, and our beautiful animals in Australia. Being a veterinarian does influence my writing. One of the common threads in my books, one of the common themes, is an exploration of death as part of life. There's a lot of sadness and grief to deal with as part of death, but it's part something we all must confront. But I'm interested in recovery from grief and how we move on, how we deal with the burdens that grief and the past and sadness bring to us, but how we move on and continue our lives after those sorts of things. So my books are also very positive. I feel very spiritually connected to the Australian countryside. My soul feels at home in Australia, especially the wild places where I love to sit and listen to the wind swirling around the rocks or little creeks running, little streams running through the grasses or wind moving in the trees, which I guess is where Le Murmure du Vent came from. This story is set very close to my home in Canberra, the capital city of Australia. It's just south of Canberra, these beautiful mountains. And I try to write about these places because I care about them. And I think in our modern society, we've moved away. We live in cities now, and often we forget about these places and how good they are for our souls. I also want people to remember about these places because if they care about them, then they may want to save them, especially as human populations grow and we press more into these natural, beautiful places. And Australia is what I know. Maybe one day I'll write a story set somewhere else, but my heart is in Australia, so that's where I write. I think I do it best. I do it best there. The Aboriginal issue is very, you know, it's very long history and very complicated. So there's now evidence that Indigenous Aboriginal Australians have been living in our country for 60 to 70,000 years. It's one of the oldest populations of humans known. And when white Australians, when white people came to Australia, only about 200 years ago, they pushed the Aboriginal people out of their country, similar to what happened in the US. And so you know, it's been very hard for the Aboriginal people, loss of their culture, loss of languages, separation from their country, which is very important to them spiritually, their connection to the land. And there, sadly, is a lot of substance and alcohol abuse amongst people who are quite lost. So this book, Le Murmure du Vent, in a way is my apology to what white people have done to Indigenous Australians over the last 200 years.